Please welcome to the stage contestant number 16. Let's hear it for Miss Dieta, Pepsi. We worked a lot together. If it sounds bad, we'd like for you to give us a brief biography of yourself for the audience and the judges.
Thank you, Valerie.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, judges. I'm contestant number 16, Dieta Pepsi. My real name is Leon Augustus Braxton Jr., and I was born December 31st in a small Midwestern town in Missouri called Shelbina, Missouri. I grew up in Kansas City and graduated high school there. Then I went to college, a jury college in Springfield, Missouri, and got a major in theater, marketing, and business. Because when I graduated, I wanted to go and open up my own theater. But in 1982, when I graduated, Reagan cut funding to the arts, so there went that dream out the window. So I got a job with City Corp Mortgage as a promotions and events marketing manager, and I worked there for 10 years. But because of something called job discontinuance, I was let go, and now I currently work for Bowman National Bank in St. Louis, Missouri as a branch manager. My hobbies include singing, acting, dancing, and playing tennis, and just having fun. And one of my lifelong goals now is to own my own marketing company. As far as female impersonation goes, I've been doing it for the past 7 years with some moderate success. I'm a former Miss Gay Missouri, a former Miss Heart of America, a former Miss Gay West, Midwest, and I'm the current reigning Miss Gay Plains. I also participate through the years in some AIDS funding organizations, and recently I participated in a fundraiser for pediatric AIDS, and we raised over $32,000. But as everyone knows, tonight, my most immediate goal is to become your next Miss Gay America, because I believe if you're gonna do something, you might as well just do it big. Thank you. In our lives, we are taught to have faith, hope, and charity. Which is most important to you and why? Once again, in our lives, we are taught to have faith, hope, and charity. Which is the most important to you and why?
Thank you, Valerie. Of faith, hope, and charity, the one thing that I treasure in my life and I hold dearly to myself is the faith in oneself. Because you must believe in yourself before you can achieve it. I go by the aspect called visualization. You close your eyes and you visualize something happening to you. Like tonight, I close my eyes and visualize the crown of Miss Gay America growing in my head. So, if you do not believe in yourself, you cannot exude confidence so that others cannot believe in you. Because I also live by this one adage: if you're going to believe it, achieve it, and just do it. Thank you.